Hello friends, in previous video we have studied the need of the condenser and what are the various types of condensers which are used in the thermal power plant. So in this video we are going to study another type of condenser, that is surface condenser. So let us study in detail about surface condenser. So surface condensers are mostly used in the power plants. They are essentially shell and tube type of heat exchangers. Now for the convenience of cleaning and maintenance, the cooling water flows through the tubes and the steam condensates outside the tubes. So figure A shows the surface condenser with two passes on the water side. It consists of a steel shell with water boxes on each side. So let us see this figure. Now the right water box is divided in order to allow the passage of the water. So the figure shows diagram for two fast surface condenser. So let us see what are the various parts. Here we have one hot well, then there is divided water box, then there is a condensate, that is a water after condensation. Here we have undivided water box, then these are the support plates, then there is one exhaust neck. This is the inlet of the turbine exhaust. Then we have one steam dome, then there is a shell, then there are the tube sheets. Then this is the inlet for the water and this is the outlet for the water. So basically the water comes in the contact with the tubes and it gets condensed. So this is the main function of this condenser. Now at each end there are tube sheets into which the water tubes are rolled. This prevents the leakage of the circulating water into the steam. So in order to avoid the leakage of the water, this type of provision is used. Now an expansion joint allows for the different rates of expansion between the tubes and the shell. Now there are vertical plates at the intermediate points between the two tube sheets to provide the support to the long tubes and to prevent the vibration. Now the hot well acts as a reservoir of the condensate with the capacity which is equal to the total condensate flow or for a certain period of time, say 5 minutes. So whatever condensate is collected, it gets collected in the reservoir. It is called as hot well. Now in a single pass condenser, as shown in figure B, the cooling water flows through the tubes once from one end to the another end. Now if you compare it with the two pass condenser, a single pass condenser with the same number as well as size of the tubes, with the same water velocity requires twice as much the water flow as compared to the two condenser, but the results are half in the water temperature rise, therefore lower condenser pressure. Therefore, a single pass condenser is good for the overall plant efficiency and reduces the thermal pollution as well. But it requires more than twice the water and hence four times the pumping water. Let us see the diagram. So the figure shows single pass condenser. Here we have the inlet for condensed water. Then this is the outlet for condensed water. Here there is the inlet water box. Then we have the outlet water box. Then the exhaust from the steam enters from this. Exhaust from the steam enters from here. Then here we have the condensate pump. Now apart from the division which is required to allow for the number of water passes, the water boxes are often further divided. For example, in a single pass condenser, both inlet and outlet water boxes are divided by the partition. This permits to take off half the condensing water out. This permits to take off half the condensing surface out of the service for cleaning while the water flows to the other half of the surface. So the tube arrangement in the condenser shell controls its effectiveness. Now the older designs tend to crowd a maximum number of tubes inside the shell in order to make available as much surface area as possible. But the modern designs have the steam lanes between the tube banks to get the maximum steam now with the least pressure drop and the uniform distribution of steam in the shell. Now the tube length may vary from 9 meter to 15 meter. This type of long tubes result in the large rise in temperature of the cooling water and the condensing ability decreases at the exit ends of the tubes. Therefore, the tubes are closer at the cold end as compared to the hot end. Now in order to minimize the unequal distribution of steam from the turbine exhaust duct to the condenser tubes, a well-tapered steam dome is added above the tube bundles. Now, an expansion joint is provided between the turbine exhaust and the condenser inlets, which permits the condenser to be rigidly mounted on the floor. Now, figure C and D shows a typical modern two-pass surface condenser for the large steam power plant. So the steam enters the tube bundles in two separate sections from the top side as well as bottom and flows towards the center of the tube nest in the next section. Now at the point Most of the steam has condensed, leaving only air and the non-condensable gases, which are cooled and removed by the SJA. This is one of the method. So here in figure C, we can see section of a typical two-pass surface condenser. Now the various parts over here are, this is the steam inlet. Then we have backwater box. Then this is the shell expansion joint. Then again we have the air connection. Then water inlet connection. Front water box. Then these are the steady plates. Here are the tube sheets. This is the reservoir for the hot water. Then here we have the section BB. We will have the section AA in the next figure. Then this is the water outlet connection. So we can see how the water gets condensed. Now here figure D shows the section of the typical two-pass condenser. This is the AA section. Now again here we have the condenser shell. Then these are the steady plates. We have the tube and the baffle. Now the material which is used for construction of the tubes may be of the following types. First is cupronickel, which consists of the combination of 70% copper and 30% nickel. Next is aluminium brass, which is a combination of 76% copper, 23% zinc and 2% aluminium. Next material is aluminium bronze, which is a combination of 95% copper, 5% aluminium. Next material is Mons metal, which is the 60% copper and 40% zinc. Now the outside diameter of the tube can be either of the three types. First is 22 mm or it can be 23 mm or it can be 25.4 mm. Now the length can vary from 9 meter to 15 meter. So in this way we have studied the surface condensers. Thank you friends for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ekeeda and do subscribe our channel Ekeeda. Thank you.